What's up, everybody?
Hey, guys. I don't want to love nobody but you. Yeah. I don't want to love nobody but you. Yes. I don't want to love nobody but you. I searched all over. I don't want to love nobody but you. You. I don't want to love nobody but you. That's right. I don't want to love nobody but you. Yes. And the church saying, come on. What's up, everybody? And welcome to Pillow Talk Moments with the Mobleys. I am your man, Johnnie Mobley Jr.
Great evening. I'm his wife, Deirdra.
And we something like an ordinary couple.
With extraordinary purpose.
Mo!
What up, though?
You want a blueberry?
I don't.
They're blessing my life.
I'm glad about it. I bought it in hopes that it would bless your life.
Blessing my life.
Let it bless your life.
I don't ever eat on the show, y'all, but...
He doesn't. It's always me.
I'm a little...
Munchy?
A little munchy.
A little snacky.
And the blueberries blesses my life.
Yeah, they have like...
My medium man.
And antioxidants.
It sound juicy. Because when I drew, hear that? Little juice all in my mouth.
I cannot stand you at
What's
all.
What's good with you, man?
I'm good. How about you? What's new?
Girl, nah. Life.
Had a good day?
It was a good day, long day.
What's good with me? You want to know?
What's happening with you?
I got that weave out my head. Oh, yes, I did. Oh, I did, y'all. She's back. It's still a little long, but I think I'm going to let her cut it. Like, cut it. For real,
yeah,
cut
you
it,
are.
Cut
you
it.
Been saying that.
Next time, for real. I am.
She ain't gonna get it.
I am.
I'm gonna put some pictures on. On our website, y'all, of her back in the day when she used to try to have more waves than me.
Oh, I did, sir. It wasn't a matter of try. It was that.
I don't tell you about that, sir. That's you being sarcastic and you trying to be.
I did have more waves than you, honey. You want me to say it like that?
It don't matter.
Either way, I had more waves.
Whatever. See, man, let me teach y'all something right quick. When your wife say something to you and it be a little sharp. Or a little hot sauciest. Mm-hmm. They try to put sweetie or honey or sir or someone in to try to make it hot sauce in your eye, but then respectable, like they ain't really did it. Mm-hmm. Oh, you got a little hot sauce in your eye, baby. Mm-hmm. Let me help you.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
See there?
I love you.
See, don't love me.
I love you. I love you long time.
Blueberry is blessing my life.
I love you long time.
What's up, Mo?
That's good, because I don't like them, but I buy them because you love them. So, it is now a few days before Christmas, and I'm excited about it.
Had the girls home.
Yep. I'm grateful. I'm thankful. Same thing. I am. How y'all doing? Y'all got your trees up. Y'all got your gifts wrapped and everything like that. We will have some stuff under the tree for the grandbabies.
For the grandbabies.
Yeah. So... I'm excited. Another reason why I'm excited. Did we share this on the last podcast that we have a Mexican theme? I don't think we did. Outside, I'm African-American. My stomach is Mexican.
I ain't never heard you say that one.
I know, right?
My stomach is
Johnny be ranking me all the time, y'all. And the thing about it is I'm lactose intolerant. So go figure. I'm gonna have to get me some tablets because I think I buy the tablets. But
will sacrifice sometimes. That's how bad.
I will, because we doing shrimp tacos, chicken tacos, may even do a little bit of steak for the man.
I'm all right.
Cause he's a carnivore.
I'm all right. I got to slow down on that meat, though, y'all.
You do.
I get myself.
I know. You
I had to get back on a trend. Blueberry, put my blueberries back in place. And
you do. Because I buy
and stuff, my snacks.
But yeah, so. But you do. You ventured recently, here recently, you ventured over to my side. And he discovered the art of a chimichanga. And so he's excited about that, y'all. So he does venture over to the Mexican side now. So with me now.
My supervisor took me to lunch. Took a couple of us to lunch. And he liked Mexican. So we went to the Mexican restaurant. And he wanted to... I asked him what he was getting. He told me. So I got the same thing. bless my whole entire life.
It blessed your life, didn't it, baby?
And I just didn't.
And then he comes home and says, babe, you want to get some chimichangas?
What? And she looked at me like.
Y'all, I knew. That's why it's cold years. Now. That's right. I had been trying to turn him on. And he wouldn't do it. So now I'm excited because that's one the chimichangas, but I persuaded you to come on over by the chorizo sausages. You like those too. Chorizo sausages, the sausage that you get from there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like in the peppers and onions and stuff like that. So, but yeah, so we ain't going to hold y'all. Like they used to say that at church. We not going to hold y'all all night.
Can I take my time?
I almost swallowed this cough drop the wrong way.
Don't rush the Lord. Can I take my time?
Okay, with you. So listen.
But what
listen.
About the ones that say, you ain't got nothing to do? And you be in your mind, be like, Joker, you don't know what I got to do. Anyway, go ahead.
You just starting off on the wrong
foot. I am. Go ahead.
Eat your blueberries.
I'm a little tired too, so.
I know. So anybody else can come out tonight besides Johnny. All them other tired characters you got inside of you.
Oh, you shouldn't have put me on this mic then.
But no, but for real, we gonna talk. That's gonna be real loud in the mic.
They gonna be like
on the recording.
What? Let me tell you what they gonna do. They gonna be like, Mr. Johnny, where you got them blueberries from? Them things sound good and juicy.
They not.
I grow the blueberries in my backyard, y'all. So this is what I do. So when we first moved here, first thing I said is I want a blueberry. I'm lying because she's looking crazy.
Anyway.
I wouldn't mind doing that though.
Well, we can do it. How about that? We'll look that up and we'll do it.
Well, I don't mind doing it. I just don't want the stuff that brings the blueberries. The things we want to eat it too. Animals.
Oh, okay. Well, we'll continue to buy them.
And we get them
from Sam's or somewhere. Yeah, the grocery store. Great.
Or go pick them. Somebody else blueberry patch.
Right. That's an idea.
That's the idea.
Because I'm sure if you can do the strawberries, you can do the blueberries from somewhere.
Y'all come with me and pick some blueberries.
We going to set that up. I want to pick strawberries, though. We'll find a blueberry farm for you. Okay?
How she put herself in.
I give and I take, baby. I give and I take.
You're right. Go ahead. You can take whatever I got, girl. It's all yours.
Oh, I know. So listen, tonight we are going to just talk about something, and I told hubby I wanted to talk about this because let me pose this question to you. What happens when you stop dreaming, you know, when, and I'm gonna start where like you I know for us, and this some of the stuff that I'm going to read to y'all, it talks about, you know, like when you're a child and you have some of the beginning of this actually sounds a little bit like one of your chapters in your book or whatever.
Okay.
But it talks about like when you're a child and, you know, people ask you what you want to be when you grow up, and like a child can name off like 5 million, you know, jobs
because
their imagination is just unlimited. And and so that's how this starts off. And, you know, so they'll say, you know, a doctor, a lawyer, a ballerina,
president,
a firefighter. I even heard, saw something where this guy was, I think it was maybe a clip based on like the funniest thing kids say.
Mm.
And one little boy, he was like, I want to be a WWE wrestler and stuff like that or whatever. And the guy was just laughing at some of the things or whatever. But I wanted to bring that into the perspective of dreaming as an adult, and like because we've shared with you all that Johnny and I work full time jobs, and that's us working, you know, in another man's dream.
Yeah,
and we're clear on that, and so. But the one thing that we always talked about is like we want to have our own dream to work in.
Yeah.
And this podcast and everything that we're doing is us working in our dream. And there are times when we get tired, guys, and, you know, we might slack on sending the videos to our, you know, our media manager.
Yeah, y'all might have caught that little clip.
Right. And, or, you know, just being weary from the day of, you know, working our full times. But, you know, the one thing that I always, and Johnnie, you know, I think when I'm kind of dragging, he'll encourage me or you know, vice versa. Yeah. And you'll say, you know, things like, you know, Mo, you know, we have to be and remain committed to doing, you know, what we talked about doing. And in order for it to come to fruition, we got to put in the work.
Yeah.
And to be honest, and I know y'all understand this because I know a lot of you have been in this space where you, you know, you may work your 9 to 5 and then you want to be kind of slack on your stuff. You know what I'm saying? Just because you're tired. From working your day job or your main job. And so here lately, I think we found ourselves because we, even though the podcast didn't premiere until March 2020, we actually started taping for it October 2019.
Yeah.
And so we were recording every week and still working full-time jobs. And so, you know, just to be completely transparent, of course, we are absolutely enjoying the ride, but it's like your mind gets tired and, you know, physically you get tired because there's still life happening.
Yeah.
And we're still pushing through to make sure that we give good, great content, you know, just be ourselves really. But just give you excellence even from our podcast. And so a couple months ago, I know Johnnie's schedule was really, really crazy. We were trying to tape in between, you know, sometimes he'd stop, take a break, tape, go back and work, answer calls, have to leave out and go answer calls and stuff like that. But, you know, we were talking about it and, you know, I think both of us were at a point where we were kind of dragging for a minute and like, Lord, you know, we, you know, just give us a refreshing, give us a renewal, give us, you know, like, I think for me, it was like, because we see where we started and where we are now, and we're completely grateful. And I know we, you know, us together as well as along with our team have written our plans for like some crazy stuff. You know, yeah. We don't know how it's going to happen. You know what I'm saying? But we know that we're going to keep dreaming, even as we write these plans out and just ask God to just breathe on them. Like, there are times when we as adults, we just get tired and we stop dreaming. And so I thought about that and I was like, but it's like, if you stop dreaming, you stop living.
Yeah, I think, and I always say this, and I encourage a lot of men, because when you work in a job, when you think about it, regardless of what it is, it is somebody else's imagination that you're working. So somebody else had an imagination. They started a company, they added, it grew, and then they added employees. So it was a dream of somebody else's that grew that now you're part of their dream.
Yeah.
So what me and Deirdra's mantra is, if we work 12, 14 hours in another man's dream, we need to work time and a half an hour. So, yeah, sometimes we be tired, we got to throw water on our face or whatever, but, you know, and there was a time that we put our dream on pause because life, just like Deirdra said, so it was us and the girls and, you know, back in the day I wanted to be a chef and I ain't had time to go to school because them girls wanted to eat now, so I had to do what I had to do. So, and now we're here and we're in our 48th chapter. How old we are, and we moving forward, but the dream was still there. We didn't let the dream die. It was on pause for a while, but we reimagined it, and then we began to pick it up again, and we began to dream again, and we're in a whole different place now. So it's completely different. God put this in us, so it ain't going nowhere. God put the dream in you. The purpose in you. So it's not going anywhere. It just will sit there if you don't do nothing with it. So
yeah,
what you see with us is us doing something with our purpose. Our heart is family and marriage. So we know the benefits of it when it's in a good spot, when the morale and the thinking and the choices are good. Not perfect, but good. Right. So we get it.
But so, I think my take on it tonight is, what do you do when you stop dreaming? And like, how do you get remotivated? You know what I'm saying? Like, how do you get that extra oomph to keep going and to keep, you know, having those dreams even when you're tired of dreaming? Or you know.
I don't think you're tired of dreaming.
Not tired of dreaming, but you're just tired.
Yeah.
Period.
Being tired will stop you from doing everything.
Right. And so what's funny, it says, do you remember the time when you used to, and I'm on Christian Today, but it says, do you remember the time when you used to dream of reaching the stars? I don't want those, baby. Or when you used to dream of becoming the leader of a state. It says, God has given us fragments of his creativity when he created us. After all, our infinitely creative creator delights in watching us make good use of our ability to imagine and dream of what is good and right. And he also delights in helping us reach great heights for him. But if you stop dreaming, it's likely that you've also lost the drive to live life vigorously and with much enjoyment.
Yeah.
And it's that part that's why I said, like, if you stop dreaming for whatever reason, because of life circumstances may make you put dreams on hold, or the tiredness of going through the process and going through, you know, to checking off the list of the different goals and stuff like that, and those dreams coming to fruition, excuse me, it's like you sometimes lose the drive, and you lose, and then you just start, I think, you just come to this place where it's like life is living you instead of you living life,
yeah.
If that makes sense. But it says, the Bible says that when there's no vision or clear direction from the Lord, people perish. That's Proverbs 29:18, y'all. We lose the passion to live when life becomes a chasing after the wind. And so I was sitting here thinking, and like I said, I shared with you earlier, it's like you get to a place where you like, it seems like it's never the dreams and the visions of things that you like literally can touch. It's like, you know, like, what's taking for so long to happen? But I remember an episode that we did, like the process versus
the outcome. Yeah.
And I know that the process is necessary. You know what I'm saying? Because it builds you. The process builds you. The process builds character.
But most people do what they do and focus on the outcome.
Right.
And
right.
Although the outcome is important, because when you put in your blood, sweat, and tears, you want to see something manifest.
Right.
At the end of the day, the process is where it's at.
Right.
Because if you can get through the process and produce the outcome,
yeah,
then you can duplicate it. You can do it again.
Yeah.
Ergo Walmart. Ergo Targets. Sam's. If you get through the process to the outcome, you produce it.
Yeah. And that's somebody, you know, that's the you know, Walmart and Sam's, that's the, what's the family? The Walton family.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's their dream. And like I said, it's not you knocking someone else's dream, because the ability to work, you know, you handle someone else's dream with excellence.
You're going to have somebody work in your dream.
Right. And you're going to want them to work in your dream.
With excellence.
With excellence. So you give that and you put that out there. But it's like, you know, I know, like I said, for me, it was just like, I was like, I think because I had become tired, I was trying to maybe talk myself out of, well, do I really want to tape tonight? Do we really need to meet to look up topics? You know, it's like, I need that extra push, God. And, you know, so whatever way, I think that's the purpose of just doing this tonight. Like, I know we're not the only people who have been in that space. And so,
and then some people might still be in that space. Let me tell you this.
Okay.
So here's a lot of times what happens to your dream when you're in your dream, working your dream, and you get tired. Because you own it, you can work when you want to, and do as that's you please.
Good. That's good.
So where there are rules, obligations, responsibilities in someone else's dream, your job, whatever it is, you push yourself to do that stuff. But then for whatever reason, you get into your own dream, then you find yourself
slacking.
Yeah. But it's your stuff, so you can do what you want to do. I tell you, we would literally tell you to reverse that. I would say do the exact same thing across the board. Just like I said, one of our mantras are, we work 12 hours in another man's dream, then we're going to work 16 in ours. We're going to work 16.
Whatever number you pick.
Yeah, whatever we
because
do.
Because it was more, even if you said 13.
Yeah, so we do this with our hearts, but the greatest thing is define the thing that you were born to do.
Right.
It's this guy I just started listening to. I've seen a couple of his things, but I listened to some of his stuff. His name is Eric Thomas. And this dude, he got a saying that he says. He said, when you want your purpose, you will be successful when you want your purpose as bad as you want to breathe.
Hmm.
And he literally got a shirt like that. And that hit me totally different. Now, I've heard that statement before,
mm-hmm.
but I ain't heard that statement at 48.
Yeah.
So when I heard, you know, him say that, he said, you're not going to be successful until you want what you want, your purpose and your drive and your vision until you want it as bad as you want to breathe.
Yeah.
Which means you will do anything how you need to do it. And I ain't talking about nothing crazy, but anything you want, anything you would have to do to get that done. And the crazy thing is, me and Deirdra, although we tired at some points in times, when we work in our purpose, it's easy.
Yeah.
It's easy. It's what we were created to do. So when you're created to do something, it's not work.
And that's when we get in here. Because when we get in here, it's like, what's up? You know, it's time to go. But it's the leading up to it. You know, sometimes when we're supposed to meet.
Yeah.
You know.
And then you have people in your life that mm-hmm. are accountable. So that hold you accountable. So we got our media team, which is a husband and wife team, and we give them authorization to push us, to enter in that space, to say certain things to us, because you need somebody to be accountable to. We're the exact same thing for them. So we push each other, that iron sharpens iron thing. Because we got some place we need to go.
We have a destination.
Yeah, we got some place
to get to. But tonight, I do want us to share some of this stuff in here because it's good stuff. Especially these scriptures.
Holding people all night now.
I know, baby. It says it's just I have a few Bible verses and they're helping me. And it says, here are some Bible verses to help you want to dream again, just like a child. Jeremiah 29:11.
Mm-hmm.
My Lord. For I know the plans I know. Have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. And that, I like to go to the Message version just to get a little greater explanation about it. Mm. So in the Message version, it says, this is God's word on the subject. Like, this is God is saying, this is what it is tonight.
Yeah.
As soon as Babylon 70 years are up and not a day before, I'll show up and take care of you as I promised and bring you back home. I know what I'm doing. I have it all planned out. Plans to take care of you, not abandon you. Plans to give you the future you hope for. Yeah. That's enough for me. That when I read that first scripture, it was like it immediately, you know, kind of turned some things within me. Like, okay, girl, get it together. Like, for real, because God ain't saying, he might do it. He said, I'm going to take care of you. I'm going to show up. I'm going to take care of you as I promised and bring you back home because I know what I'm doing. And when God, where do you think those dreams and visions and different things come from? They come from him.
Yeah.
He puts everything that you need is already inside of you. And so that's what this brings to me. Lord, God's saying, I got it all planned out. I done wrote the blueprint. It's already written out. I just need you to believe it. And I need you to know that it's gonna take a process to get you to where the end point that I got for you to be. So come on. Like you used to always talk about, Peter, you gonna get out, you gonna get out the boat, sir. You getting out. You getting out today or tomorrow. When you coming? Nope. And so I feel like it was an illustration that was so powerful that our apostle used like, you know, God is saying, okay, like, come on. It ain't that God ain't trying to figure out nothing because he's already done it.
Yeah.
But it's up to us to keep dreaming, keep having, you know, the visions.
Stay connected.
Keep writing the stuff down. Keep talking to him. Keep asking him to show you because y'all, even with this podcast, there are things that that have yet to be seen.
Yeah.
But we're here for the ride. Like, we are committed, literally, we're here for the ride. No matter what, we are going to watch this thing unfold because it's too exciting and God is just too good for us not to follow this out. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because I think if we didn't, we would always be like, what if? Mm. Why did we or why didn't we follow it through? It's like, you know, when you're in purpose, it's, you know, it's hard to explain it, but it's like, you know, and for the times when you think the enemy try to get in your head and say, you know, what y'all doing ain't making a difference. You know, it ain't changing no life. Mm. You know what I'm saying? It ain't, you know, it ain't bettering nobody or whatever. You'll get that text message.
Or get a reminder.
Or you'll get some type of reminder. Or you'll get a phone call. Or you'll get... It's a nugget that you'll get from some whoever God decides to use.
Perfect stranger.
To give it to you to say, I hear you, daughter. I hear you, son. Keep on going. Yeah, I gave you those dreams. I gave you those visions. I gave you all of that. And I gave you everything inside of you. Just keep going. Keep walking. Oh. Even though it looked crazy. Even though you got, you know, you gonna mess up and you gonna fall down, but get back up. Brush your knees off, you know, brush your hands off and keep it moving because I got you. Yeah. So the next one, 1 Corinthians 2, 9 through 10. However, it is written, what no eye has seen, what no ear has heard, and what no human mind has conceived, the things God has prepared for those who love him. These are the things God has revealed to us by his Spirit. The Spirit searches all things, even the deep things of God. His ways are greater than ours. His thoughts are greater than ours. So ain't no eye seen it, Johnnie. Ain't no ear heard it.
So you talking about...
Oh, God.
So let me put this part in there. So you having that big dream inside of you, but... You looking at somebody else work their dream,
mm-hmm.
and you saying they ain't living. I'm making good choices. I love the Lord. I ain't hurting nobody. I'm helping. I'm serving, and they over there doing whatever, and they getting all this stuff. I say to that, stop putting so much energy into somebody else's stuff, because what's for you is for you. I make that parable, or that. Example about Peter getting out that boat all the time, because at some point in time you got to look at the people around you, who's in your circle, who you hanging with, who you bumping with, who encouraging you. Are those the people closer to you? Peter was in that boat with 11 men, and Peter got out the boat and walked, and 11 men sat in that boat and watched Peter walk. Mm. Who you got with you that just watching you and they're along for the ride? And you might walk on the water, but when you get to the other side, they're going to want you to come get them while they're still in the boat. You believe, but they didn't. But they reap the benefits. It's your dream. It's the gift. It's the purpose that God put in you. And it's new. It's something nobody's never seen. Imagine that. Just stop and imagine that for a second. In 2020, going into 2021, there's something inside of you that the world has yet have seen. They haven't seen.
Yeah.
They haven't seen, which yeah. means it's brand new.
It's brand new.
And they waiting on you to bring it because it's going to help somebody. It's going to fill somebody's light. It's going to serve somebody. It's going to encourage somebody. It's going to get somebody. It's going to be the missing piece to something else to build an empire. You never know. But it's brand new.
Yeah.
Your dream. Brand new.
Yeah. Yeah. It says, the Message Bible says, we, of course, have plenty of wisdom to pass on to you once you get your feet on firm spiritual ground. But it's not popular wisdom. The fashionable wisdom of high-priced experts that will be out of date in a year or so. God's wisdom is something mysterious that goes deep into the interior of his purposes. You don't find it lying around on the surface. It's not the latest message, but more like the oldest. What God determined as the way to bring out in his best in us long before we ever arrived on the scene. He been did it. But it said he ain't about to do nothing. He's already done it. The experts, right. The experts of our day haven't a clue about what his eternal plan is. The experts don't have a clue. Mama ain't got a clue. Daddy ain't got a clue. God knows what his eternal plan is for us. It says if they had, they wouldn't have killed the master of the God-designed life on a cross. That's why we have this scripture text. It says, no one's ever seen or heard anything like this. No, nobody, Johnnie. No one has ever, never so much as imagined anything quite like it. What God has arranged for those who love him. That's what qualifies us. Because we love him.
Yeah.
Point blank, period. So it says, you know, like the things that he wants to do. The things that he, not a man, but God. That he's prepared, the things God has prepared for those who love him. All the things that he's prepared for us who love him. And ain't no mind, no ear ain't ever heard it, and no mind can brand ever new. Conceive it.
Brand
it's
new,
brand new. New. New, new. Yeah, new, new. Is that for me? The things that God has prepared for those who love him. And it's revealed to us by his spirit, which it's got to be relationship, y'all. He had to go, but he left his spirit.
Yep. And it's there for you if you
yeah,
want.
Yeah, and I invite him in every day. Every day. Every that. Day. Okay, y'all, I'm gonna give it to y'all, the rest of this. Then people brought, this is Matthew 19, 13 through 14. Another one of the scriptures. Then people brought little children to Jesus for him to place his hands on them and pray for them. But the disciples rebuked them. Jesus said, let the little children come to me and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these. Mm-hmm. Let the little children come to me and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these. And now I'm gonna tell y'all what the Message Bible says about it. So that's, I'm writing Message, y'all, instead of Matthew. Bear with me just a second. Matthew 19, 13 through 14.
I'm going to say this real quick.
Okay. I found it. Okay, go ahead.
Go ahead.
The Message Bible says, one day children were brought to Jesus in the hope that he would lay hands on them and pray over them. The disciples shooed them off, but Jesus intervened. Let the children alone and don't prevent them from coming to me. God's kingdom is made up of people like these. After laying hands on them, he left. Hmm. Leave them alone. Let the children come to me. Don't prevent them from coming to me. But God's kingdom is made up of people like these. I want to always have childlike faith. That's my desire. Never stop dreaming. Always believing that the impossible can happen and always waiting for God to blow my mind. Point blank, period. What is it that you were going to say, babe?
There's something that my media, one of the media managers told me about, I'm a big reader and I listen to books on Audible. I'm always trying to get some type of information in my head. So she told me about this book called The Big Leap by Gay Hendricks. Now, I've read and listened to a lot of books that motivate you and encourage you. But this book was some kind of different because it brought something to my attention that is actually real, but we don't know what it is. You ever went after something, you ever started something and it started going and you got the momentum on it and it began to go to the next level. And then the next level, and then the next level. And then it got to a place to where it got a little too much. Excitement, success, all that stuff came with it. And then you find yourself dismantling everything that you worked hard for, everything that you built. Because in your mind, you couldn't stay there because that wasn't what you're used to. Mm-hmm. So you find a way to get back to what you're used to. Follow me. It made so much sense. So everybody has a space of genius. Everybody. And to get to that place, it requires you to experience like unlimited joy. Mm-hmm. But some people destroy that joy because of past stuff. They don't think they deserve it. Mm-hmm. They don't think they should be there. They don't think they can do it. They don't think they have the endurance to go as far. So they somehow mess it up and then take that nudge in their belt to say, well, I tried. I got so far. Yeah, remember that? Yeah, I did pretty good in that time. That's when I was doing. But what if you'd have just kept going? What have you just experienced and kept going? So, did we just cut off?
Hey, light.
How you feeling? But what if you just experienced, and I'm still reading this book. It's absolutely a powerful book. And most books, I can either read the first page or listen to like 30 seconds of the first page and I know if I'm going to like it or not. And this was actually a book that I didn't think I was going to like because of how it started out. And now I'm about halfway through the book and it's pretty amazing. It's bringing some stuff to light. It's exposing me to some stuff that I, in my own life, can see. Mm-hmm. Like it's been times where I was doing stuff or we were doing stuff and we was going to that upper limit place to where we was in that genius spot. And then somehow we just wind up being back to our comfortable place. Mm-hmm. So, and just to give you a basic example of what I'm talking about, there's a reason, one of the examples that he uses is a reason why people who win the lottery, no matter how much money it is, they somehow always find their way back to where they were before they won the lottery. Mm-hmm. Somehow. They win millions, billions of dollars, and then you hear about them in 5 years, 3 years, 5 years, they're back to where they were. So they don't put a plan in place, they don't do nothing, but they spend the money until they get back to their comfortable place. And that's a basic example of what he's talking about. So what he's talking about is a lot more deeper. That thing that you were doing to get you to that place to where you were at the top of your game and something. And then somebody came and said something foul or said something against you or somebody came and wanted you to go to another level that you didn't think you can do. So you kind of stayed where you was at. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's that place to where if you ever heard of the natural and the supernatural, that's why I take that to. That's why I receive that as a supernatural. So it's something that you're not supposed to explain, you're not supposed to be, but your genius moves into a place to where it's closer to God's supernatural. Because now you're moving, you're walking on the water because you believe you can do it. Not because of your powers or your strength or your ability, but because of what God put in you, you believe you can do it.
But all of these scenarios, all of these scriptures, all of these things are leading you back to understanding that all of this stuff comes from God.
Yeah.
And literally, the light want to be bougie tonight.
Was the light broke?
The light want to be bougie tonight, y'all. The light said he's tired too. He's tired of dreaming too.
I'm understanding that.
Hey, light again.
But I just have one more to share. But like I said, all of these, it leads you back to the scripture, of course, we know, you know, is God's word. And it's leading us, it's what it's giving us is that I'm God, I change not, I'm always with you. If I gave you the dream or the vision and all this stuff, like, don't put it to the wayside. Thinking that it's not going to come to pass. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm going to require you to put your hands to the work. You know what I'm saying? It ain't just, as you always say, he's saying, I ain't no magician, you know? But you're going to have to put in the work.
Yeah.
But instead of looking at what you have to do to get to until things manifest, just keep your eyes on me.
Yeah.
And just keep coming. And that's what, you know, all of these verses is leading you to see. Like, God is saying, I've already done it. I've already created. It's already in you.
Yeah.
And don't let the tiring moments, don't let the, you know, when you're fatigued from working in somebody else's dream, don't let the life circumstances, don't let, because a child is going through something and you may be, you know, have to tend to that or something is going on in your marriage and you may have to deal with that or whatever. But at the end of the day, like, don't lose hope, don't lose faith, and don't lose sight of what I've already told you.
Yeah.
It's like when you don't see it manifest, you know, I guess in the time frame that you have in your mind, you begin to think, oh, well, it ain't gonna happen. Or it's taking too long to happen.
Yeah.
So maybe that ain't the right dream. Maybe, you know, I was tripping and that ain't the right thing. But in essence, what he's saying is, Just come on. Just trust me. Trust me. And even when you don't know what to do, trust me. Even when you don't understand what's going on around you, trust me. Mm. Point blank, period. I have another one.
Mm.
It says
she preaches. She feel like preaching tonight, y'all.
No, I'm not.
Will there be one?
I'm just telling y'all what is. What is helping me?
Will there
y'all
be one?
They play all day, all
the doors,
day long.
The doors I'm just are always saying open. Will there be one?
There is somebody out there who is losing hope.
Yeah. Who has and already lost hope.
Who has lost hope and who's tired and feel like, you know, God ain't there and he ain't with me. You know, like being mad at God and like, you know, you gave me this dream, God, or you gave me, you know, this vision. You gave me these things. You gave me these things to do, like, you know, like, where you at? And he say, you know, I'm here. I'm here. I ain't went nowhere. I'm not going to leave you. I'm not going to forsake you. I'm here. But instead of focusing on being tired, like I said, instead of focusing on things that are not going to fuel you, think, you know, focus on me because I got you.
Yeah.
You know, in street term, I got you, boo. You know?
And don't get to that place to where you focus on me and then you start moving and then you get familiar with me.
Yeah.
And now you think you got it.
Yeah. Or you think you know what he how he gonna do it?
Yeah,
or how he gonna come?
That's what we get in trouble at. We do it with him, and he get us to moving, and then we be like, all right, Lord, I kind of got this. Like, yeah. Peter was like, okay, I done took about 700 steps. I'm good.
I got this around. By myself. No, you don't.
You don't.
No, you don't.
You don't. You never had it by yourself.
No, you don't.
He never. Here's the thing. What the purpose that he put in you was never meant for you to do without him. He has to be a part of it. He has to.
Okay.
For it to last. For it to change people, for it to change and have an impact, for it to help, he has to be a part of it.
Amen. I'm gonna get a swig and then I'm gonna tell you.
All right. Now I'm gonna take up. You want an offer?
And then I spilled water all over my side, but it's okay.
Cash App Queen Dad.
It's okay, y'all. That's really not my Cash App.
Oh, it's not. Don't say nothing to that, please.
You're crazy. The last one is Genesis 15:1-6. And as I stated at the beginning, y'all, these are scriptures to help encourage you when you have stopped dreaming. Or, you know, the last one is, did I go past it? Oh, baby. The last one is Genesis 15:1-6. God took Abram outside his tent and said, look up and at the sky and count the stars. If indeed you can count them, then he said to him, so shall your offspring be. Abram believed the Lord and he credited it to him as righteousness. In the message, y'all, it says, after all these things, this word of God came to Abram in a vision. There you go, vision. Don't be afraid, Abram. I'm your shield. Your reward will be grand. The Lord is my shield. Abraham said, God, Master, what use are your gifts as long as I'm childless and Eliezer of Damascus is going to inherit everything? Abraham continued, see, you've given me no children. Abram continued, sorry. See, you've given me no children and now a mere house servant is going to get it all. Then God's message came, don't worry. He won't be your heir. A son from your body will be your heir. Then he took him outside and said, look at the sky. Go outside, Johnnie. Apostle told a message. Come out of the tent. I think that was what it was talking about. Look at the sky. Count the stars. Can you do it? Count your descendants. You're going to have a big family, Abram. And he believed. God believed God. God declared him set right with God. And he believed. And at the end of the day, that's what he's saying.
Yeah.
Believe me. Don't focus on what your circumstances are right now. But believe my word.
And you know,
trust my word.
Everybody who has faith, we're not saying not to have faith. But we tend to focus on faith and not believing. Faith without works is dead, which means you got to believe what God said,
right.
And then you got to move.
Act on, right.
You just don't believe. I got faith. He go do what he said, Lord. You go do it. And while you sitting down, he go do it. I believe him. I've been here for 7 years. The number 7 mean. The number 8 mean.
Well, they can tell you what every number mean.
But you ain't moved yet.
You know, we heard him, and so we told y'all, we started recording that day on the way from Jacksonville.
Yeah,
and we believed that we could do this. You know what I'm saying? We was like, okay, well, Lord, we heard you. We believe we can do it. We have faith in you that you're gonna bring everything that we need to get this done to start this.
And the crazy thing was. Our plan. We was gonna write a book.
Well, yeah.
I done wrote a book. You know, we gonna do this. We gonna write a book, which the book is still coming.
Yeah.
The perfect recipe for your relationship.
But
we had it backwards.
Yeah.
So we was gonna write the book, trying to find time when to write the book, and then we literally he gave us that a nugget that morning, and we said, what would happen if we did a podcast? Not like a podcast. Ain't nobody finna listen to us. Who gonna listen to us? Well, we counsel, so I mean, people listen to. Yeah, people need.
I help. Literally went online and printed out all these ways of how to produce a podcast everything. And all this stuff or whatever.
And the one
and
thing,
this is the iPad, y'all, that we recorded on. It's probably still on here, all muffled and everything. But at the end of the day, we believed God. And we asked him, okay, now, if this is something that you want us to do, for real, you want to send the people to do it. Because we don't know what we're doing.
You know we...
Obviously, we don't know what we're doing.
We can do the research. We can do all that stuff. But we're not experts in this. And we don't want to give the stuff that you've given us, we want to put it out there in excellence. So we don't want to just do anything. We don't want to just be on a phone all the time. You know, so God, we pray, God, send us who we need to partner with.
Yeah.
The very next day, we had the exact same name. We didn't talk about it. We prayed about it. And we got the exact same name. And then the rest is history. From that point on, we move forward. We believe we out the boat, we walking. We're not saying we don't take our eye off God every now and then, because it happens to all of us.
Yeah, fatigue will do that.
It happens to all of us. But at the end of the day, you look back at him. You really got your phone on?
I do.
At the end of the day, we keep put our eye back on him. So yeah, and now we so far out on the water now, y'all. Every now and then I look back for the boat. Because I'd be tired. I'd be like, I want to sit down. And I don't even see the boat no more, y'all. That's how far out on the water we are. So pray our strength. Matter of fact, pray our strength. And we pray y'all come on out here with us. That dream you got in your belly, that idea, the vision, all that is the exact same thing. Why you not doing it? Why is it out here? Why you not doing it?
Yeah.
We know you can't do all of it by yourself. Trust somebody. Hire somebody. Get somebody in your life, in your circle, that you trust and move forward.
Yeah.
Everybody don't want to take advantage of you. Everybody just don't want your money. Some people want to see you do great, and then they want to partner with you because you got something that they need as well. So you partner together, iron sharpens iron, you keep building it. So that's what we're building here, is a legacy. We're building a legacy. We're building a team, not only for us, but for other families.
Yeah.
That's what we're doing. And we're going to keep pushing. And we're going to keep doing it. And every now and then, you're going to see us go up on the water.
Don't.
But when I go up on the water, she grabbed me by my collar and said, Joker, get up.
Yeah.
I grab her by her collar. Well, she don't go all the way down because she ain't trying to mess her hair up, so.
Why it always got to be shade? It always got to be shade.
She ain't finna get her hair wet. So she go down, but once she get to this part right here, she lift back up. Like, okay, Lord, I'm back on you because this hair.
Y'all, the word of the Lord said, then God's message came. Don't worry. Don't worry. Don't worry. That's in his word. He said, don't worry. The promises of God, that's where I was trying to go to, y'all. The promises of God are still yes and amen. Whoever that's for, take it. The promises of God is yes and amen. Not the promises of Buddha or Muhammad or all these other folk out here. The promises of God is still yes and amen. And that's what he wants you to know and to understand and to believe and to cling to, that he hasn't changed his mind about you or you or me or you or you or you or you. He hadn't changed his mind. And if he said it, it's going to come to pass. And that's what he wants you to believe. And so much so that he says, you know, like, remind me of my word.
Yeah.
And we do. And we are, because we trust him so much, even the moments that we look like we starting to waver, you know what I'm saying? He immediately, like, just sends that reminder to us, even in a time of prayer or a time of worship. I got you. Yeah. Like, for real, I got you. And I remember, like, it probably was my grandma, because she used to say a lot of stuff like, you can take that to the bank. I remember that. Like, yes. And I remember that saying. Like, God is saying, you can, that's a done deal. That's a cash, that's a check that you can guarantee is gonna be cashable, because my word will not return to me void. And so that's what I'm holding on to, y'all. So that's all I was, you know, that's all we was coming on here to say tonight. Like, hold on, keep dreaming, you know, keep expecting, but keep working too. Because as Johnnie said, faith without works is dead, and he ain't going to just come sitting in your lap. So we could have very well said, okay, God, we're going to do this podcast and just sit back and wait for somebody to call us.
Selfie stick.
Or whatever.
It's us again, y'all. Moments with the mobile to say, hey, baby.
You so crazy. And literally, yeah, try to do it with that. Or furthermore, just like you said, just, you know, just be like, oh, I'm just waiting here because the Lord said we're going to do a podcast. Well, yeah. When are you going to do your part?
The dream is real.
Yeah.
Our dream is real. The dream God gave you is real. Move in it.
And are you going and do it scared? Do it scared.
Don't be scared.
Yeah, but even if you are
success.
Right. That part.
Because that's a part that I learned that I had to be honest and transparent with myself.
Yeah.
Are you afraid of your geniusness? Are you afraid of your success and where it will take you and how far you will go?
So you try to sabotage it. Yeah.
So you get to a point where you try to go back to your comfort zone and you don't live there no more.
But that's a real conversation even before that book, even before you were introduced to that book.
Yeah.
Because remember the conversation that, you know, that we had even when starting this, and you were like, baby, you ready for this? You know, you ready, you all out there, you all in, you know, you just ready, you know, to do it, ready for this life. And it's like, I was wondering, you know, and I would say to you like, baby, what do you mean by that? Like, if this is what the Lord, this is what the Lord has given us, and we've prayed about it, and he's put the things in place for this to be able to go forth, I can't not sit back and not do it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I can't, I know that he wants us to live a fruitful life. I know that he wants us to live a life full of joy. I know that, you know, what he has is ours. And so how dare we ask him
for it
and then be afraid to go after it or be afraid to put the work to it and sabotage ourselves from getting to what he has for us.
Yeah.
For me, I feel like that would be like a slap in, you know, God's face. Like, you know, we asked for it, but we don't really want it. We ain't really want all that or whatever. But I always tell you, Johnnie, to whom much is given, much is required. Yeah. There is much in us.
Yeah.
And for us to be selfish and hold it, that ain't God.
Yeah.
It's not. It has to come out. Because for us to say that we are Christ-like, that we are representatives of Christ, it means that, okay, we have a relationship with him.
Yeah.
And he needs us in the earth. I'm sorry. He needs us in the earth to do it. Because he does things through people.
Yeah. And we don't have to be ordained as pastors or bishops or apostles. He can use us.
Yeah, everybody has their specific our lane and title and all these things. Stuff. Yeah.
He can use us just like we are.
Yeah.
With our country talking sales, with our whatever sales, he can use us. Because like my wife always says, we might not be for everybody, but we for somebody.
And the thing about that is, Johnnie, is he's not a respecter of person.
Yeah.
So you who's watching, you who's listening.
You who going to tell somebody about
it. Right. Who's been contemplating on moving on the things that God has given you and the dreams that you have dreamt. And you can, Johnnie used to tell me all the time, because his dreams were always more vivid than mine. And he'd be like, babe, I see, you know, us going around the world and having, you know, conferences, and I see us speaking. And he would even go to the detail. I remember the one time you said about one of the girls like ministering or in dance, and you know what you could even say what she had on or whatever. But in that moment, I know that it was real to you because you could explain so vividly, you know, of what it was. But to get to that, it's going to take it's going to take us walking some things out. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's going and so the part that you can't be, that we have been, we are determined not to be afraid of, is the walking out of it. Yeah, because us walking it out is helping to shape us and mold us and form us.
Build us up.
Build us up. You know, give us a thicker skin, you know, give us more endurance, give us more, challenge us in areas, because there are things that we're going to have to know how to do and know how to articulate when we get to these places, because our lives aren't our own. If we say God use us, then our lives are His. And so who are we to be selfish because somebody somewhere is tied to your dream? They wait on you to get to that place so they can collide with you.
That's real.
Yeah. So somebody is waiting on us.
And here's the thing. The process is the process. You learn what you have to learn in the process. But the main thing that you learn is the connection and relationship with God. Because when Peter was walking on the water, the Bible didn't say it was just sun shining and the water was just clear and all this other stuff. It could have been all kind of things going on. But because he kept his eye on God, it didn't affect him. So some of the stuff is for the process to build you up, to get you prepared for where you're going. And then the other stuff is to get your belief up. Because now you're going to face something that you wasn't planning on, you never saw, you didn't expect this, and you can't go back down and run back or destroy or go back to where you got to walk through it. You got to go through the process. And this is the part where you stay focused on God and he gets you through it. Because while all this stuff going on outside and your flesh can see all this other stuff, your spirit will get you through. Your connection with God will get you through. Your relationship will get you through to where you got to go at, to where God got you destined for, and you will get there. But that's the part. You will never be prepared for everything.
There's
no way.
Never.
But what you can do is have such a relationship with God, not a perfect relationship with God, but a relationship with God to where you focus on him and he gets you through it.
Mm.
You just got to believe.
Amen.
You just got to believe. So my wife got on here tonight, Minister Mobley. She needed to say this word that was in her belly.
That's you.
In her belly.
Y'all, I said it because it's real.
She was full. And I think
it's true.
It came from a real place. We had something remind us today.
That came through who God uses. Yeah. Us, a person.
And it wasn't nobody that knew us. They didn't know my name. They called me husband. They knew Deirdra's name because she was actually on the platform. But what she said was dead on. What she said was
God
dead on.
God is mindful of us. I think that's what, you know, we're in all of this. That's what we're saying. He's mindful of us, God, y'all. And he has orchestrated everything that concerns you. And he wants good. He has a spectacular, you know, future. He has, you know, all these things he has prepared for those who love him. And we know that we love him, and we know that we're not perfect, but we strive to be more and more and more like him every day.
Yeah.
And so I know I'm not, and I know you've been, you
I don't even try to be perfect.
Right. But you are determined even now more so, like, Lord, whatever you have for us, it is for us.
Yeah.
So we're prepared for God to do some crazy stuff.
Not only in our lives, but in y'all's life too.
Yeah. So we need y'all to expect that. And if you stop dreaming, if these any of these scriptures have helped, take them and eat on the word and digest it and get it in you and repeat it. You know, daily, if you know, that always helps to build your spirit man up and stuff like that or whatever, because it helped me, y'all. And I just wanted to share that with y'all. And, you know, we had a conversation about some stuff today. So just know God got y'all, and he ain't a man. He ain't going to lie to you. His word ain't going to return to him void. Mm. It's going to accomplish that which it was set for.
But you got to believe it.
It's going to accomplish every single thing. And I believe it. So I need y'all to jump back on the wagon, those who may have stopped dreaming, like, and tell God what you need him to do. Like, God, I want to dream. You know, give me vivid dreams. Give me dreams that I can remember when I wake up so I can write them down, you know, and help me. And, you know, I like I tell y'all, every morning, if I'm not saying it in the morning, at some point in my day, I'm like, okay, thank you. Great morning or great day, Holy Spirit. Like, I don't want you to leave me. I want you to stay with me and lead me and direct me and guide me, you know, into all truths. You know, what do I get to do for you today, God? It, you know, is I think a posture that just helps you not to focus on what may not be going right. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, y'all, I'm, you know, just trust God, put in the work. Trust God, put in the work. Keep moving. Keep moving. Because we running in purpose, y'all, and we ain't stopping. So thank y'all. I just had to encourage y'all because I was encouraging myself
as
I was saying it, y'all.
She was encouraging.
Amen.
She talked herself happy.
I did. You know, it don't take much.
It don't take much.
It don't take much.
She loved it, Lord.
Okay, she loved it.
It's okay, baby. It's okay. He is good. He is good. He is good. So, y'all, we're going to close out now.
We about to go, y'all.
I pray that this... We really pray that this helped, man.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, don't stop dreaming. And I will even go as far as to say, today is the 22nd.
Yeah.
You got how many more days for the end of the day? 8, 9, 10. 8 days. 8 days.
It's 31 days in the year.
9 days.
In December.
9 days left for God to expect God to
blow
do something
your mind
absolutely phenomenal in your life.
Yeah,
it's not over.
Yeah,
it's not over. It only takes a moment for God to get you. You got to believe.
Yeah,
just believe. It don't take much.
Our prayer for you all tonight is that you would dream vivid dreams and that they would just you wake up in the morning and be like, oh my God, what
and
was
believe
that?
It. Write it down.
Yeah,
put something by your bed. Write it down, have you record on your phone, talk about it, do something.
Amen.
Do something.
Amen.
I can tell you this, there's one thing that I learned, I don't know how many years ago, but when you write something down, man, it makes the difference.
Yeah.
When you write the dream down, when you write a strategy down, when you write your plan down, when you write your blueprint, your task list, or your it makes a difference.
Amen.
You get stuff done. So we going to get out of here before my wife start preaching again, y'all.
I'm not. I love y'all. Y'all go to bed. Drink you some sleepy time. No, don't drink the sleepy time, T. That might put you in a
just lay down. She just told you to dream. Now she's telling you to take sleepy time.
No, don't take the sleepy time, y'all. Rest. As I told my daughters, rest in the Lord. Mm-hmm. Amen. That's my prayer. That's
all right,
our prayer
y'all.
For y'all.
You good, Mom?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm great. Amen. Amen.
This has been Pillow Talk. The Christian Pillow Talk. This has been Pillow Talk. Moments with the Mobleys. I am your man, Johnnie Mobley.
We Christians.
Johnnie Mobley Jr.
The Lord is with us. He is in us. And I'm his wife, Deirdra, y'all.
And
amen.
We something like an ordinary couple.
With extraordinary purpose.
We out of here, y'all.
Night
y'all be
night.
Easy. Have great dreams tonight. Heavy,
amen.
Heavy, heavy dreams. And
amen.
Write it down.